this copy of PowerChurch is set up as I've just converted from a prior version of PowerChurch. So if I go to Payroll now, it says Finish Payroll Conversion. This process is not quite as in-depth, but there's just not information that we had from prior versions to be able to get you set up and running in version 11 correctly. So we click Next. Here again, we have our payroll departments. Click Next. Positions, all these are optional. If you want to add position or department, go ahead and do that. Pay groups. Now, we already had monthly and weekly pay groups defined in prior version, in our last version of PowerChurch, but we didn't, in the last version we just had one letter. Now we have a whole description. So we can come in here and we can click Edit. And instead of just saying Group M, you know, we now know that this is church staff. So we're going to change that to church staff. Group W, this is our daycare staff, and they're paid weekly. We have a former employees group, so this lets you have a more English-like descriptions of the groups rather than just single letters. Now, this is asking for each tax table that we found in version 9 or 10 of PowerChurch, what type of tax does it calculate? So we double-click each of these and scroll up here for federal. And we're going to say, well, this is federal withholding. This is federal tax married. And the other thing that we need to put in here is the withholding allowance. That was back from the circular E gave us that number. And we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to scroll up to federal withholding. There is one bug right now that will be fixed next maintenance release. When you first come in here, it says generic tax table. If you put a number in here, that will withhold there, and you won't be able to edit any longer. So before you enter any numbers in here, scroll up and change it to federal withholding, and then go edit any of your particular numbers. And the annual rate here, this is what was entered in version 9 or 10 of PowerChurch. That's converted over, so I'm not having to retype this here. So we're completing the conversion. In version 9 or 10 PowerChurch, there wasn't a place to put in this annual withholding allowance other than on the individual. So that's why this part's not filled in at this point. And for Medicare, we're going to go up here and tell it that this is the federal Medicare rate. And we're going down here to tell that this is North Carolina state, and our deduction amounts, we have to give it. This is our married. So our married standard deduction was $3,000, and our withholding allowance is $2,500. And for our Social Security, we changed the tax table to Social Security. And we click Next. Now, it's asking us to confirm what each type of item it calculated. It's going to try to make its best guess at what it is. But in version 9 and 10, there was no pre-tax deduction, so the 403B withheld says after-tax deduction, so we need to edit it, and we need to tell it that this is a pre-tax deduction, which means it's going to change the amount of taxable income that somebody has. But on the rest of these, federal tax came across as federal tax withholding, state tax came as across state tax, Social Security is Social Security, Medicare is Medicare, health insurance we're going to have set up as an after-tax deduction, and a 403B, a retirement deduction, is going to be a pre-tax deduction. In fact, I need to set that as a retirement deduction, and we're going to go ahead and tell it's 403B, retirement deduction. Now it's asking specifically for the employer liability items. We're going to tell it it's a tax item and Social Security, and that this is a tax item in Medicare. Things that you could have in here as a non-tax item for employer liability would be the employer portion of the health insurance premium or the employer portion of a retirement plan. It can be set up as a non-tax item as an employer item. Now, income items, it's asking us for how to treat each of these. So for pastor's housing, we need to come here, tell it's a housing allowance. The rest of these we can leave as it is. And we can click next because everything else will be treated as taxable. And now it's asking for the number of allowances for each item. So for Selena, she had one, she was claiming one on everything, so it's asking us to edit each of her state and federal items to put in the number of allowances. And I can edit those just by either double-clicking them or highlighting and click edit. And it's going to confirm your federal and state employer IDs. And that's finished. So that's completed. Listen, that's complete, giving the conversion process the information it couldn't pull out of your prior version of Power Search.